us to be with you all across this beautiful land of Guyana and across the entire world, wherever you view us from, in your vehicle, at the bar, at the beach, wherever. We thank God for this opportunity that we can be with you week after week. And we thank God for you that you make the time to join us. So we welcome you this time and we ask that you stay tuned. God bless you.
This evening we want to continue our discussion we started last week on the benefits of fasting and prayer. And it was Jesus who said in Matthew 4:4 that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. There comes a time when we have to, and we must, if we're going to advance in the things of God, separate ourselves from food and separate ourselves from things, from pleasantries. And because the fasting is and prayer is so important, because it helps bring you closer to God. It helps you to be sensitive to the word of God, what God is really saying. And the persons might be bound by some kind of addiction, fasting and prayer. You know, you could be set free even as you tap into God as your source. We are able to discover also weakness, or weaknesses that we have. And this allows us to draw strength from God. So we talked about spiritual benefits. There are also mental and emotional benefits that can be derived from fasting. And one of these benefits has to do with relief from anxiety and nervousness, and bringing peace to one's life. And so one must always set aside some time to do this. And even as we're engaging in the Daniel fast, we've already heard reports what God is doing in the lives of people in relation to these benefits. So we want to continue the discussion on the benefits of fasting and prayer, gentlemen.
Last Sunday, in our congregation, our bishop, Reverend or Bishop Messiah, preached a wonderful message that really touched my heart deeply as he spoke on the issue of the value of fasting and the power of God that is available, the strength, the spiritual strength that is available. And there are three things I thought that I should mention on this program. He said, he made the observation very clearly, the biblical observation, and the scripture is clear, Jesus made it so clear, that when we give, which is an instruction and a requirement, not if you give, but when you give, when you pray, which is also an instruction, it's not optional, but it's something that must be done. And when you fast, taken from Matthew, and lots of times we believe that we're doing God a service when we do these kinds of things, but it's a requirement for our own sustenance and strength and our own development. And what I have found over the last few weeks that this is our second week that we're on this fast, and even in the past, there is a kind of spiritual alertness. It's not just strength, it's not just losing of weight, but your spiritual antennas go up. You become more aware and conscious of the spiritual elements in the environment. And as a result of that, you and I benefit. And so as we are fasting right now, you find that God is opening our eyes to the different kinds of things that exist in our environment, even in our own lives, and he is bringing the power and the strength necessary to bring the deliverance that is needed.
What do you like about this whole period of fasting? I mean, Reverend Hudson made mention of Jesus when he introduced the program. He said even Jesus himself, you know, said in his word that man shall not live by bread alone, but every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. In that context, Jesus was actually himself fasting.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, Jesus fasting. Well, once you're living in this flesh, once you're in this flesh, the word of God says there's no good thing but light in the flesh. When we actually fast, we bring the flesh into subjection.
Amen.
And the spirit man is empowered. And what aids in this process as well is an understanding and a constant massaging of the word of God. Jesus was tempted, and in all three instances, we see him use emphatically the word of God.
Right.
All three scriptures he used, they were found in Deuteronomy. Amazing. So, if Jesus himself could have fasted and been able to withstand and repel the attacks of the enemy, how much more we need to come into this environment where we could really reach out and find tremendous victory in our lives as we move forward in the things of God.
Jesus said, it is written.
Mm-hmm.
It is written. It is written. We need to immerse ourselves in the word of God. In our own strength, we are no match for the enemy.
Mm-hmm.
But as we read the word of God, it not only strengthens our spirit, but we're able to thwart the attacks of the enemy because we can quote the word of God and say, Satan, it is written. And more than that, as we confront situations, we confront difficulties in our lives, we can speak the word of God into those situations. And it not only bring hope to us, but we can see walls broken down, we can see chains broken from the lives of people, and we can see captives set free because of the power of the word of God. So as we fast, it's not just depriving or just excusing ourselves from pleasantry, but it's immersing ourselves in the word of God so that we can be strengthened and so that we can be edified and do the work of the Lord.
Just to piggyback on what you said, Pastor Lee, you mentioned seeing captives set free. I'm not at liberty to say all that I need to say, but during this fast, I had an encounter where a colleague of mine began to manifest. And using the anointing and the power of God and the word of God, I saw that woman set free.
Amen.
In the office.
Amen.
Set free by the power of the Holy Ghost. And that woman, when she caught herself, she could not believe what was happening to her. And I strongly believe, like we are saying, and it was endorsed before, when we set ourselves apart from pleasantries and we allow the spirit to come into connection with the spirit of God, and we are empowered and emboldened. Jesus himself said, greater things than these shall you do. And I strongly believe as we hold fast to his word and we press in to closer walk with him, we will be able to accomplish a lot and see many persons delivered and set free.
Is this the fast that I have chosen to lose the bonds of wickedness, to undo the heavy burden, to let the oppressed go free, and to break every yoke? Isaiah 58:6. And I believe that this exactly is what we are experiencing, where the power of God is dismantling structures and systems that the enemy would have established in our life and our community.
Jesus, Mark highlighted something in the life of Jesus. And in Mark chapter 9, Jesus had just come down after being transfigured, and he met a crowd with his disciples. And they were asking, Jesus asked, what's really going on here? A gentleman steps out of the crowd and said, you know, my son has a dumb spirit. And this demon would
cause him to convulse, foam at the mouth, and he will throw him into the fire. And while he's trembling, and my son is uncontrollable. And Jesus looked at the father and he said, how long has this been happening to him? And the father said, ever since he was a child, he'd be thrown in the fire, thrown in water. But if you can do anything, the gentleman said, please have compassion and on us and help us. And Jesus said to that man, if you can believe, if you can believe, all things are possible to him who believes. If you can believe. Now the father's response is interesting. The father said, Lord, I believe. Help thou my unbelief. Lord, I believe. Now, I think his mind, his intellect was getting interfering. I believe. I mean, all these years, you mean that if I just believe, something will happen? And the Lord said to him, if you believe, all things are possible to him who believes. And immediately Jesus commanded the spirit to come out of him and let him go. And that happened. The spirits obey. The trigger is, if you can believe, wherever you are, if you put your confidence in God, in the Word of God, you hear the Word of God,
yeah.
And you we are introduced to him through his word.
Yes.
And by the power of his Holy Spirit. If we can just expose ourselves to the word of God and believe his word.
You know, that
will be the beginning of something tremendous in your life.
Yes, I think critical to this whole, the whole meaning of belief in this context, it has to do with your faith, you know?
Yeah.
And faith is described as what? The substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. And here is where sometimes, you know, the greatest miracles, the greatest transformation, and the exhibition of power, the power of Christ, is found in your faith. Could you imagine? And Jesus himself said, if you have enough faith, as a mustard seed, you will say to this mountain, be thou removed. And it will be removed. And you know, I remember looking at some videos with Reinhard Bonnke, you know, the evangelist, and the bishop, he kept talking about belief, and he said lots of times the disciples were not able to accomplish many things because they did not believe. And that tells me that you could be in a setting, you know, in a church setting, and still not being able to be victorious because the belief is not there. So, you know, some of the disciples, they were astonished by what Jesus was doing. But Jesus said, you know, if you have faith like a mustard seed, this will happen. And so belief is so important. So you might be going in your homes, wherever you are, you might be going through some rough times. And you're saying, man, you know, it's all over. With your faith, if faith come alive, you could see transformation and change.
At the end of this example that I was referring to, when the young man was delivered, he fell as though he was dead. Now, this is in the public domain. We had a reference here where Minister Wesley pointed out about something happening in the workplace. God works any place.
Amen.
Yeah.
In your workplace, in your home, in the marketplace, in the church. And so this is in the street, in the public domain, and this young man was set free. However, it looked as though he was dead. When those demons left, he lay there in the street. I could imagine people saying, Jesus killed the boy. You know? And Jesus took him by his hand, and he rose, and the young man left. Well, of course, his father must have been extremely happy for that work. But let's go to the close. crowd dispersed. The disciples are shocked like those people. They come into the building and Jesus holds a seminar with his leaders. They ask him, why couldn't we cast those demons out? And I want you to remember these words of Jesus. Jesus said to them, this is Mark chapter 9, verse 29. Jesus said to them, this kind can come out by nothing but prayer and fasting. Hence, one of the reasons why we do this. There are different kinds of spirits. Some who oppress and some who possess. Jesus said, this kind here, you could jump how long you want to jump, make a lot of noise, but they wouldn't budge except you pray and you fast. So we invite you. The doors are open at the church. You can come during this period. Whatever kind you have, you can come.
What a wonderful time to come into the presence of God. The word of God says, him that cometh to God must believe he is. And he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. There is nothing that he cannot do if you believe. I like this fella. He came to the Lord Jesus Christ. And the Lord says, if you believe, it is possible. Things can happen. The life of your son can change. He was possessed. Jesus is able today to deliver you. And the church is in a mode of fasting and praying because we are believing God that he will break down structures set up by the enemy to cause mayhem and destructions in community, in families, in lives. Yes, structures have been set up. But during this period of fasting, we agree believing God to see the chains of bondage broken from the lives of people, young people being set free. We believe in God for our own communities, for our own families, for our nation. And during this time, it's a wonderful time to tap into God. Because as you come and you believe God, see the power of God come in an unprecedented way and destroy and root up and sever the ties of the enemy from your life so that you can go free.
I must piggyback on that last statement you made about that seminar that Jesus had with his disciples and the value of fasting and prayer. Lots of us don't believe in demons, you know. We don't believe because we are in this physical world. We believe that the physical world alone exists. And I believe that there are three advantages demons have when you think like that. One, you don't see them, so you believe they don't exist. Two, they have been in this world for a long time, so they have a knowledge of human and human behavior. And then three, they have the power to move around prince and power of the air. And so we sometimes operate as if they don't exist, they don't have, we don't care about them, but they are there. And some of them are not known, little demons, you know. Like in the case of this young man, there are principalities and powers that control systems and structures and communities. And unless you have a greater power, accordingly here, he's a military man, you will be able to help me here. But unless you have a greater power to throw this strong man will sit right there and watch you and laugh. And especially since you don't see them, and then physically you don't see them. And then two, they have an understanding of who we are because they've been among human behavior and experiences. They've seen our patterns. So imagine you have an enemy you fighting like that. Unless you have the power of God.
The power of God is here right now. The power of God is what you like about Jesus. Is what I like about Jesus. This is my Father's world.
Yes,
for God so loved this world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever
believe in him shall have everlasting life. And we saw in Hebrews 11 and 6, he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. You have to come to the consciousness that you need God. People need the Lord. Amen. You need God to deliver you out of those very circumstances that you are unaware of. Some of the demons that might have been humbugging, as we put it, or hindering us, our progress in life, is as a result of connections that were perhaps made in the past, that, you know, our future might have been mortgaged.
Yeah.
But here we have an opportunity to go before God, and God will reveal things to us that normally, under all circumstances where we fill in our stomachs and so on, I particularly have an eating habit. I don't like to give it up until I feel the weight in my stomach, you know, which is bad, you know. Sometimes we eat too much, but this is an opportunity now where faith is coming alive and you are manifesting the spiritual man and not necessarily the physical man. Let us fast together.
You know, the first time, we spoke a lot about belief, but I remember the first time I decided to engage on a prayer and fasting. I didn't believe I could make it. And I dare say, and I confess that I really did not make it right through. I slipped up a few times. Because for me, food was very important. Pastor David alluded to it. And the thing about it, food is important to us, let's face it, because it's essential in the physical world for our sustenance, for our survival. But you see, the thing about it is that when you give up that which is so critical, so important to your physical survival, and you make it because of your trust and faith in God, it helps you to realize that, you know what, you can make it. There are some situations that you can overcome with God. And that is what helped me to rise, to tap in to the reservoirs of faith that I had, because I recognized that I disconnected myself from that which that I needed to make myself. You notice all of the things I use, and talk about I and talk about myself. Everything was about me. But when I let go and I did not try to do it on my own, and I now relied wholly and solely on him, my faith in him was increased. And then I was able to overcome situations that I could not have otherwise overcome.
You know, what you have done is to substitute, you know, one power for another in terms of giving up, you know, the food. Because lots of people believe that, and many of us too, you know, because when, you know, you hear Daniel fast in the early days, yes, I wonder if we can do this thing again. Because you're thinking about the beef and the chicken and fish
bread,
and the
bread
and the beef and the shark. But the thing is, once you launch out, you begin to understand that you could make that substitution. All you have to do is to start. And once you start, you recognize that you have the ability, because spiritual power is far more important than natural power. And that is what you get when you fast, spiritual power.
What I like about Jesus, I'm finally able to say that, is that he sets the foundation of faith.
Yeah.
If we're going to be victorious in this life, we need faith. If we can only believe, we shall receive. Mm-hmm. But he didn't stop there. And as you alluded to, this kind, so it means there's a point in time that you could have all the faith that you could possibly have, but some kinds, it seems as though there's an hierarchy of evil, and a hierarchy of, you know, structural evil. And even as we think about this nation, we need to really come into a place where we could fast and touch God in a real special way.
Yeah.
Because there are certain structures, notwithstanding our faith, and faith is critical. Faith for most cases will bring us into the victory. But fasting kind of like tunes up our faith. It brings extra strength. I mean, look at Jehoshaphat when he was engaging with those three armies that was coming up against him. He called a national fast. I mean, that was amazing what he did. There is a direct correlation between the victory that that was had and the fasting of the nation. And perhaps that's something that we need to romance as we go forward as a country, because I mean, when we look at our struggles, you know, we see them just manifesting themselves periodically, and then, you know, it would go away and then it would come back again. Perhaps this is something that we need to enjoin in our forces so that we could really see the victory.
At this time of the program, you have introduced a major concept of warfare, spiritual warfare, and the benefits of fasting. Because whether we consider the individual, and we are not standing by ourselves or on our own foundation, each one of us, yes, you watching this program, you stand up on the shoulders of your ancestors, and we don't know who they introduced or who they made a covenant with in the past. The thing about spiritual power is that once a covenant was established sometime in the past, they remain faithful to their covenant, and they come and check each generation to see if there's an open door.
Yeah.
Once there's an open door, they seal that deal there ancestrally. Now, what the fast does, and Jesus provided significant insight when he said, some of these experiences we have, they will only budge when we pray and we fast. We pick this up when we meet again. God bless you. The doors are open. Come 5 in the morning, 6:30 in the evening. You'll be blessed.
We thank you for joining us on Choices Today. Remember, you can join us at First Assembly, LNP Durban Street, Wertmanville, Georgetown, Guyana, for any of our special services. I'm Salacia on behalf of the set, reminding you that your whole life is the sum of your choices. God bless you.